Hello friends, welcome back to our video lecture series on course titled Fluid Mechanics 2. In the previous lecture, we have discussed velocity distribution in open channel flow, in open channel and one-way approach, which is used to analyze the open channel flow. In this lecture, we will go through some geometric elements related to open channel. So while solving the numerical or while analyzing or deriving some equations, you won't get confused related to that. D is the depth of channel. And y is depth of flow. Sometimes it is also denoted as y0. In case of uniform flow, it is referred as normal depth, which is not going to change over the length. And d is the depth of channel, that is total depth of channel. And if I am considering the total depth of channel, it doesn't mean that my channel will be fully filled with the liquid, flowing liquid. So my depth of flow might be less than that depth of channel. So in that case, my y will be the depth of flow, which is less than the depth of channel. And while we are dealing with the open channel flow, in some cases where we might have used d as a depth of flow, or might be we have used y as depth of flow, so remember that both are representing the depth of flow. In this case, I am just defining it as a depth of channel, but wherever it is coming, y or d, both are used for the representation of depth of flow. Now A is the area of flow. What does it mean, area of flow? That means that I am considering this area of cross section of flow. I am not considering area of channel. I am considering area of flow. That means that this would be my area of flow. My area of channel will be more than the area of flow. So here it is my area of cross section of the flow. Next one is the hydraulic radius, which is the ratio of area of flow divided by weighted perimeter. Please remember that this weighted perimeter is the length of weighted section. So if I measure this weighted section, likewise, so if I measure its total length, so it will give me the, it's okay. So what is my total weighted area? It means that whatever the water which is come in contact with the surface, so this is the length over which my water is come in contact with the boundary, over this length also and over this length also. So if I want to compute weighted perimeter over which my water is come in contact with the boundary, so I can simply say, in this case I can simply say it as, it is first y plus bottom width b plus again y. So I can simply write it as b plus 2y. This will be my weighted perimeter. Remember the concept of weighted perimeter. It is that portion over which length water come in contact with the boundary. Next one is the hydraulic depth. It is the ratio of area of flow to the width of flow, top width of the flow. So remember that our top width is different, t, bottom width is different. In case of rectangle channel, both will be the same, but in case of trapezoidal channel, both would be the different. Again, in case of triangular channel, so in case of trapezoidal channel, your top width and bottom width would be different. So let's say this is the surface of the liquid. So in this case, this will be my top width and this will be my bottom width. So in this case, my bottom width will be the slightly lesser than the top width. So when I take the ratio of area of flow to the top width of the channel, it is known as hydraulic depth. Remember the difference between hydraulic depth and hydraulic radius. Hydraulic radius is the ratio of area of flow to the weighted perimeter, and hydraulic depth is the ratio of area of flow to the width of flow, top width of the flow. Next one is the section factor, which is given by the equation z is equal to a under root of d, where d can also be written as a by t. So it is coming as z is equal to a under root of a by t. So I can also write down by taking this a inside the cube root. So it can also be written as under root of a cube divided by t. This is the section factor z. And section factor for the uniform flow, it is given by a multiplied by r raised to 2/3. And for the critical flow, it is given by z is equal to a multiplied by under root of d, or under root of a cube by t. Remember this and don't try to mug it, because while we are going to derive those equations, or while we are going to make use of it, so you will get remember it itself. So no need to mug it. So those are the elements which I have shown here. If you see here, this is the rectangular section. This is Y, this is B, this is top width. In case of rectangular channel section, B and T both would be the same. This is the depth of channel. Again, here it is depth of channel, here it is depth of flow Y, here it is bottom width, and here it is top width. In this case, top width and bottom width both are different. Now, in case of closed channel, circular section, this is the depth of flow. And in case of trapezoidal channel, this is the depth of flow, and this is the top width. Now, whatever the slope, those are shown here. Z is equal to 1, and here it is again. Z is to 1. Whatever this slope of this slides has been shown here. And in most of the cases, we have used this Z as n to 1, horizontal to vertical. Those are the some area computations for the geometric element, different element. For the rectangular, area can be calculated as B multiplied by Y, and weighted perimeter can be calculated as B plus 2Y. Just we have seen an hydraulic radius, it is the ratio of first two columns, that is divide one column number 1 divided by column number 2. Trapezoidal, B plus 2Y multiplied by Y, this is the area, and B plus 2Y multiplied by Z square plus 1 raised to 0.5, that is under root of Z square plus 1. We are going to derive the equation for it in the later session, so don't worry about those formulas. Again, for the triangular, ZY square 2Y multiplied by under root of Z square plus 1, and this is the hydraulic radius. In case of circular channel section, area can be calculated by using D square multiplied by 2 theta minus sine theta divided by it. Weighted perimeter can be calculated at D theta, and here it is the ratio of first two columns, where the theta is the angle made by the surface of liquid at the center. So if the surface of liquid is lower than the center of channel, in that case this theta will be measured from the center. Here it is, and here it is, and this angle will be the theta. Hope you understood those geometric element related to open channel flow. Those are the references which I have used for the preparation of this lecture. Thank you for watching.